You make me feel so young. You make me feel so spring has sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you speak, I wanna go play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon just like a toy balloon. You and I are just like a couple of tots running across.
Welcome everybody to my show, the movie cabin of Dr. Mike Face. I am Dr. Mike Face, and in this show I show off the DVDs, VHSs, or possibly Blu-rays, if I buy them, that I bought in the last month or so. It's been about 2 months since I did my last episode, so I'm excited to do it now because I've accumulated a lot of tapes. So this is going to be my VHS side to my video. I just did my DVD. Check it out. I'll send a link at the bottom. So let's get started here. I got a lot of horror VHSs. This is Clown House, the notorious Clown House, directed by Victor Salva, and everybody knows the horrible events that have taken place during the making of this movie. I will not discuss it. I don't like thinking about it, but and talking about that, I was like, really, I really, really avoided this movie for a long time, finding out about that. But I get a lot of requests on my top 10 clown movies about it, and I'm like, well, I do like Victor Salva, and I like his movies Jeepers Creepers 1 and 2, and I'm like, you know what, I don't have to like the man, I could still enjoy his work, and I definitely like this. It definitely has some weird scenes in it, but it's definitely a really good clown slasher film. If you like clown slasher films, this is definitely one of the best. If you can't get over the whole Victor Salva thing, I don't blame you. Clown House. Up next is a non-horror, Road Trip. What can I say? This movie is just hilarious. It's a really funny movie. It's got Tom Green in it, and you don't see much of him anymore. So if you like movies like Rat Race or the American Pie movies, this is for you. Road Trip. Up next, Warlock. I love this movie. Julian Sands stars in it as the Warlock, and he stars in the second one. These are definitely really good movies. I found out about this because I'm a big fan of the Leprechaun franchise, and there was a graphic novel that is conjoint with the Warlock ones. I'm like, wow, I definitely gotta check this out. It's really, really good. If you like witches and stuff, this movie came out in the late 80s, I believe. Whatever. This is a really fun movie. If you like movies like Wishmaster, this is definitely up your alley. I think these are a little better than the first two. There is a third one, which I do have on tape, and I haven't watched it yet. I don't know when I'm ever gonna get to it. Just not very appealing. Doesn't have Julian Sands in it, but Warlock. Up next, a Joe Dante movie called Matinee. I found this at a thrift store yesterday for $1, and I've always wanted to see this movie, so I'm taking the time. I haven't seen it now. Seems like John Goodman, it takes place in the early 60s, 1962, with the whole atomic age of movies, and everybody is scared of the big bomb. And John Goodman, from the trailer, it seems like he plays like a director, definitely based off Alfred Hitchcock and more so William Castle. It looks like a really good movie. I definitely want to check it out. Matinee. Up next, it's a movie I have on DVD and VHS already, but I don't have this copy on VHS. This is Tales from the Crypt, the movie from Amicus. I think this was released in 1974, I believe. Stars freaking Joan Collins. I love her. I loved her on the Batman show as a siren. I always bring that up. And Peter Cushing, who's one of my favorite actors of all time, next to Donald Pleasence and Vincent Price. This is a really good movie, and compared to the show, I don't think it's better than the show, but I like this movie surprisingly more. Well, I love the show, don't get me wrong, but this is just a really cool freaking movie. Definitely check it out. Tales from the Crypt. Up next, a non-horror, Get Over It. I bought it mainly to do with, because it has Mila Kunis in it. It's funny. It's got Martin Short in it, and I think he's great. Get Over It, if you like late 90s comedies, teen comedies, Get Over It. It's up next for you. Up next, one of my favorite freaking series of all time, Ernest Rides Again. This, I believe, is the fourth installment to the Ernest series. This was one of my personal favorites, Ernest Rides Again. Jim Varney, definitely in my top 10 favorite actors of all time. I think he's just freaking awesome. Ernest, I just love these movies. I'm planning on collecting all of these on VHS. I have some of them now. I got Ernest Slam Dunk, Ernest Saves Christmas, Ernest Goes to Jail on VHS, and I have another one I can't remember as of now. But Ernest, if you love Scared Stupid or Saves Christmas, Ernest Rides Again is definitely one of the best. Ernest Rides Again. Up next, it's a movie I haven't watched. I bought it at this little library that donates some of their movies and books, and they were selling VHS tapes for two for 25 cents, and I looked at it. Seems like it's in the late realm of movies like Scream, but a little more science fiction-y, and Final Destination, just by the style on the cover. Mimic looks good. Up next is I watched this for the first time when I bought it. This was also at that little bookstore, two VHS for 25 cents, starring Mike Myers, So I Married an Axe Murderer. Definitely not one of his best movies, in my opinion, but I definitely enjoyed it. You see where he got a lot of inspiration for the Austin Powers movies in this. He has, he plays two roles in this. He plays a gentleman who's looking for love, and he just can't seem to find any places. Scottish obsessed father. He's really good with the Scottish accent. Brings it to Shrek and other characters. But it's pretty cool. If you like Austin Powers, you like Mike Myers in general, definitely should check it out. So I Married an Axe Murderer. Up next, it's another tape that I bought at that little store, 2 for $25 at the little bookstore, Gosford Park. I haven't seen this yet. And it's pretty long too, and it has an Academy Award winner. And from what I know, what interests me to buy it, it's a murder mystery, and I love those. I love Clue. I love Murder by Death, movies like that, and A House on a Haunted Hill. So I definitely want to check it out. Looks like definitely an intense movie. Gosford Park. Up next, another kind of murder mystery movie, Laura. Starring one of Vincent Price's early films. Definitely dig this movie. It was directed by Otto Preminger. I can't pronounce his name. He starred as Mr. Freeze on the Batman show in one episode. This is definitely a really good movie. If you love noir, like 50s, this is a 40s film. This movie's great. Definitely check it out. And if you like Vincent Price, this is for you as well. Up next is this is Paula Abdul's music videos from her first album. I love Paula Abdul. Think What You Want. I love Madonna. So this was definitely up my alley. I bought this at a thrift store, Goodwill, for $1. And the music video is really well done. I think she's a great choreographer. She did the choreography for the Oliver Stone's The Doors. She did Val Kilmer's choreography. So she's pretty impressive. So Paula Abdul. Up next, Doctor Who and Daleks Invasions Earth 2150 AD. This is definitely a little cheeseball movie. It was made by the company Amicus. Definitely, I love this movie. I watched it, and I definitely want to get the other one. This, I believe, is the second one out of the two. With Peter Cushing, just does a great job. He's probably going to be my favorite Doctor. I'm not really into the series, but I definitely love this movie. Doctor Who. Up next is one of Marilyn Monroe's most notorious films, especially for the scene when she's over the little grate and that air blows up the 7-year itch. I saw this at Goodwill, and I love Marilyn Monroe. She's a fucking babe. And I haven't seen it. And it definitely looks like a fun comedy, and, you know, can't go wrong with Marilyn Monroe. So, 7-year itch. Up next, her last Finnish film, Marilyn Monroe, The Misfits. And I have yet not watched this either. It stars Clark Gable, Marilyn Monroe, and Eli Wallach, who just died this year. He played the ugly in The Good, Bad, and the Ugly. And this movie seems like it's a really, really powerful movie. There's a lot of hype about it. It seems pretty controversial for his time, so The Misfits. Up next, this was also at that little bookstore I was talking about, and I already have this. This is John Carpenter's Halloween, starring Jamie Lee Curtis. It's the Anchor Bay release, which I already have. I just bought it. It's like I said, why not? It's in pretty good condition. I definitely want to show off my Halloween DVD and VHS collection for Halloween this year, so hope you guys look forward to that. Halloween, John Carpenter's. Up next, this was also at that little store. I just bought a lot of their tapes. This is Charlie's Angels Full Throttle. Sorry. I haven't seen this one yet. I've seen pieces of the first one. I liked it mostly due to Bill Murray. Bill Murray is not in this one, and I haven't seen. It's got Demi Moore in it, and she's a babe too. And also stars late Bernie Mac, and he's awesome. I love the Bernie Mac show, so I'm looking forward to watching this. Charlie's Angels Full Throttle. Up next is kind of another random buy from that store, Ocean's 11, starring George Clooney and Brad Pitt, and Julia Roberts and Matt Damon. I really want to see the original, starring the Rat Pack, you know, Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, Sammy Davis Jr. I really want to see that compared to this, but I saw like 10 minutes of it on TV once, and I'm like, this doesn't seem too bad, so I'm definitely going to check it out, Ocean's 11. Up next, last but not least, River's Edge. I bought this on Amazon, and my friend showed me this, Dr. Gonzo Boogie. Check out his videos. He rocks. He showed me this video. It was an early Keanu Reeves and Crispin Glover movie. It's really, really good. It's based off true events. It's about these group of high school kids. They have a friend, and he tells them that he murdered his girlfriend down by a river, and at first they don't believe him, but then he goes and shows them, and it's all about how they go about it. It's a really, really intense, really cool movie. Dennis Hopper's also in it, so I recommend this to anybody. River's Edge, great movie. Oh, actually, I lied. There's one more film. I didn't see it there. Space Raiders. This is definitely a knockoff of the Star Wars movie, but this is cool in its own rank. Roger Corman produced this. It's a very fun. I enjoyed the hell out of this movie. Definitely check it out if you're into 80s space, Star Wars, Star Trek. This is for you. This is really, really cool. Definitely check it out. And it's like an original Warner Brothers VHS tape, and I like these original clamshells. So, Space Raiders. Okay, if you like my videos, give me a thumbs up. If you want to leave a comment, leave it at the bottom. So, have a good day.
You make me feel so young. You make me feel so spring has sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you speak, I wanna go play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon just like a toy balloon. You and I are just like a couple.